we meet again. Is it a coincidence? Or maybe it's fate?
Yeah, sorry about that. I've been watching way too many TV series recently.
We are here to talk about a pair of truly wireless earbuds. These are, in fact, the cheapest ones I found on Amazon.in. They only cost me about 1500 rupees, and frankly, they are not half bad. These earbuds are made by a brand named Vaburs. Strangely enough, there isn't a single mention of the brand name anywhere on the packaging, or even on the product itself for that matter. The only place where I could find the logo was on this thick, foamy carry case which they provide in the box. The picture of the item on the box really matches the product itself, so I don't think it's the wrong package or something. Not really sure what's going on here, but let's just move on for now. When I first took the cradle out of its plastic bed, I was surprised by how heavy this thing is. It's also a lot more thicker than I thought. That's what she said. No, it isn't. She said it was a tiny and cute thing, which is precisely what I thought when I looked at the earbuds within. They are both made of rather thin quality plastic and are very lightweight. Weirdly enough, there is no label to separate the left one from the right one. They are practically identical. You can even swap their places in the cradle and they still fit perfectly. The only way to find out which one is which is by putting them on. Once they are connected to each other, they will announce whether they are the left channel or the right channel. You can then swap them afterwards if necessary. What's interesting is that this cradle also has a spare battery built into it and a USB Type-A outlet. That can only mean that this thing can deliver power to a secondary device like your smartphone with the help of a secondary 2600mAh battery built into it. Yeah, they straight away ripped up an idea from the Noise Shorts X5 and gave a built-in power bank feature to their earbuds. But hey, they are cheap. And speaking of cheap, let's get to the sound output from these. It's strictly fine, nothing more. The earbuds have a glossy plastic finish, so they are inherently pretty slippery in your ears. And despite having the right ear tip size, they do fit a tad bit loosely in your ears. In fact, these were the first truly wireless buds that ever fell out of my ears on their own. That never happened before, and that is not cool. Again, let's remind ourselves that the price tag here is just 1500 rupees, and attempt to swallow this minor inconvenience while we move on. The call quality on these was pretty mediocre as well. I had to talk rather loud when I was wearing them on, and occasionally I had to hold the right one right next to my mouth so the other party would hear me better. This is actually not uncommon among truly wireless buds. Even the Sensor BS01, my daily drivers, have the same issue, where I have to pull out the left earbud and hold it next to my mouth if I'm in a noisy place. And they cost nearly twice as much as this one, so there's that. Functionality wise, these both act as independent earbuds, but somehow turning off the right earbud immediately turns off the left one as well. Turning them back on has to be done separately though, but this leads me to believe that the right one is the master earbud which communicates with the device. Although they both have the same basic set of mediocre controls. By mediocre, I mean it's a fairly limited set. They both have push buttons which are pretty easy to feel and press. A single button on either one of them toggles between pause and play, whereas a double tap on either one of them just skips to the next track, and that's it. There are no other controls like changing the volume or redialing the last number. I'm cool with that because once I play something and set a volume on my device, I rarely ever touch my earbuds for anything other than pausing the media. And that's exactly how they are intended to be used, with an optional skip feature to be used when you feel like it. By far, battery life is the strongest point of these earbuds, or Vaburs buds as I call them. The built-in 1500mAh battery provides tons of juice, and the earbuds last about 3.5 hours on their own. There's also that super useful secondary battery on there to charge your phone and other devices, so that's pretty cool too. The battery indicator in this is a single tiny little blue LED which blinks multiple times to indicate the battery percentage. 4 times indicates a full charge, 3 would mean 75%, 2 would mean 50, and 1 would mean it's 25% or below. It does take up a pretty long time to charge these things because considering how great their batteries and how huge they actually are, I'm not surprised. But it can be overlooked because it does act as a very efficient power bank in the time of need. You just have to find the right time to charge them, like during lunchtime or something. Okay, so to summarize,
we have ourselves an extremely affordable product with pretty good build quality, average sound output, fantastic battery life, and a nifty little extra feature. Should you consider buying one? Well, of course, why the heck not? I mean, sure, they are an unheard brand which are offering you a product which you don't really know in a sketchy box without a brand name. But hey, at least it's cheap. That's something. Seriously though, I have used these for quite a bit and, like I said in the beginning, they are not half bad. Anyway, that's been it for now. I'll leave a link in the description if you would like to check out these from Amazon. I'll also leave a link to my blog, dopetechfever.com. And with that, I'll see you with the next crappy video. Bye.